biggest challenge, if you ask any CEO or any senior manager, they say, you know, the biggest problem is people problem. Now, the data actually solves the people problem. Now, how does data solve a people problem? Because the bigger problem in people problem is that their lack of experience and their lack of homogeneity in their execution of work. So if this means that if you give a task to A, B or C, all the three people might not be able to do the same work at the same level of quality with the same understanding. Right? The difference between these three people, bearing about their IQ, the basic IQ, is their understanding of the sub-problem, availability of data, and their ability to interpret data, and experience. That how do I evaluate what this data mean and what decision he should take? And the wrong decisions are actually the biggest difference between A, B or C as three individuals who are empowered to do the particular job. And another problem is that if you don't have empowered people, nothing moves in the organization. Nobody takes a decision. So to take decision, you need experience. You don't have all experienced people in the organization. So what does analytics do? So analytics basically gives you insights. And these insights, which are basically converting the very, very light signals that comes out of the business, right, into strong signals. It converts, it gives you an idea that, okay, if this particular data says this, this means this. Until and unless this knowledge and capability is available to each and every individual inside the company, it becomes very difficult for him to take decision with conviction. So analytics provide conviction when you take decision, and therefore eventually you can actually delegate decision making to your lower levels inside the organizations. And that is the power of data analytics. Now, a lot of people confuse data analytics with AI. Right? Let's not jump to reach artificial intelligence and machine learning. Right? The most important thing is to first do data analytics in the proper way. That itself can create a massive amount of value for your business. Once you have done that, then obviously you need to create systems which can self-learn and which can automatically create new models and new ideas. Right? Then you go to a level of machine learning. And then eventually you evolve to artificial intelligence, and that takes time. It's not going to happen on day one or day two or day three of your becoming a data-driven organization. So you have to have patience and you have to eventually build to that. But the beginning starts with something very simple. You have a lot of data. How do you analyze that data and how you can actually create a data-driven organization?